Hello and greetings from Iceland, but just after I posted a long update about earthquakes yesterday, a new earthquake swarm started and everything is on high alert again. And a volcanic eruption is very likely in the next hours or days. But I am going to try to keep this short now, but go over the main points, which are that the civil defense has asked people not to go to Geldingadalir. And the state broadcasting service has turned on the live cam again, so I'm leaving links to all available cameras. What is happening now seems to be a direct continuation of the unrest that began at Mount Keilir, but faded out after we saw the lava intrusion move from this mountain, Mount Keilir, toward Geldingadalir, in the direction I'm showing you here. And then we noticed a land uplift south from Geldingadalir in a rather large area. So it was very clear that something more was in the pipes. And last night, I could see it hour by hour as the intrusion started to move from where it stopped, midst between Mount Keilir and Geldingadalir. It moved rather fast and the epicenter is now close to the crater. And the scientists say that magma has been accumulating at 11 kilometers depth there for months. So I'm going to give you the links to the best tools that we have to trace it. The live earthquake view has a very low resolution map, and the other map where you can look up earthquakes back in time is not handling the situation, meaning that you will only see the larger ones since they don't appear there until they have been overviewed by the experts, but they can't keep up. And the third map explains why our experts can't keep up overviewing them earthquakes. It is actually a website that has been teasing me. It might be a browser problem on my side, but I'm having a hard time zooming in because the map resets every few seconds. But you can see the number of earthquakes in the last hours. And as I was looking at it last night, there were about 200 earthquakes every hour. But now, when I'm making this video, they are just over 100. But the fourth tool is the most useful now. It's online. map.is, and from there you can add an earthquake layer on the satellite map. And when we compare the last 6 hours and the last 24 hours, we can see what was happening last night. Or the intrusion moving south to Geldingadalir is exactly the same pattern as you noticed before the eruption in Geldingadalir started. The only difference is that it might be easier for the magma to reach the surface now. And the location of the next eruption is the biggest question. The most likely scenario is of course that the Geldingadalir eruption will pick up again, just only a few days after it was formally declared as over. But there are some bad signs that we should be concerned about, and I'm going to use my good old map to explain them. In this case, a topography map with the lava field from the Geldingadalir eruption. And I'm directly over the place where the earthquakes are now, just south from the crater. And this is how it looked in September, just shortly after the eruption stopped. So this has been the epicenter of the earthquakes for the last hours, but I'm turning the camera now, and what worries me is that the earthquake swarm is also under the so-called Nátthaga Kriki. It's a valley, and this is how it looks. The barrier in front of the valley was made in order to prevent the lava from flowing down there, and it did hold. But we have to keep in mind that it is just a matter of a few meters. If the lava from a potential eruption will flow south or west. If it goes south, there is only one farmhouse at risk, but if it flows down to Nátthaga Kriki, everything is open. There we have a geothermal power plant, the Blue Lagoon, and then the town Grindavik, which is our greatest concern, of course. And the barriers around Grindavik have already been planned. And judging from the power of the earthquakes, the complete picture with the Reykjanes Peninsula, and the fact that the intrusion broke its way to Geldingadalir, where there is now a channel to the surface, we are pretty sure that this will end up with an eruption in a matter of days at the most, even in a few hours. So you have all the tools to follow this, but the main issue is the location, and I will be covering that later on better when I have more time. Our scientists have not said very much about this so far, but we will get more news later on tonight, and I will add them to the video description if I see a reason to. And of course continue to be on the lookout and use my footage to explain the situation as well as possible. But one of our experts did, however, say today that he expects a similar eruption as we had in Geldingadalir, but we have to bear in mind that it was a small eruption on Icelandic scale, so it would not surprise me if there is something more in the pipes now. But we remain hopeful for the future and the physical town, so I'm yet again linking to my full video about Grindavik, where I used to live and work for many years. A town that I would not like to see go under lava, like all Icelanders. So until my next update, most likely tomorrow, I'm sending you best regards from the Volcano Island, Iceland.